हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ राजुल सुथार, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ श्री स्वामीनारायण इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी पार्ट गांधीनगर। इन प्रीवियसली वी हैव डिस्कस मोस्ट ऑफ द कंटेंट ऑफ सर्वलेट एपीआई एंड इट्स ओवरव्यू। प्रीवियसली वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट सेशन एंड सेशन मैनेजमेंट एज वेल एज URL रीराइटिंग। इन दिस सेक्शन वी विल डिस्कस द कुकीज। सो वट डू मीन बाई कुकी? हियर नेम ऑफ द कुकी इज रिटन java.x.sublet.http.cookie। सो वट इज द जनरल आइडिया अबाउट द कुकी? कुकी आर सम लिटल इन्फॉर्मेशन दैट कैन बी लेफ्ट ऑन योर कंप्यूटर, दैट इज कॉल्ड क्लाइंट कंप्यूटर, बाय द अदर कंप्यूटर वैन वी एक्सेस एज एन इंटरनेट वाइल वी आर वर्किंग विद नेट और परफॉर्मिंग ब्राउजिंग some data. So cookie automatically stored in your browser like Chrome, Firefox, Opera. Generally this information is left on your computer by some advertising agency on the internet. Using the information stored in the cookies, this agency that perform the advertising, that can keep the track of your internet uses. And for the application like on online purchase system, once you enter your personal information such as your name, email ID, then it can be remembered by the system. The system will remember, and with the help of cookies. So these cookies are very much dangerous because by using the information from your local disk, some of the malicious data may be passed to you. So it is up to you how to maintain your own privacy and security. Here we will discuss, so in that work with the simple HTML form, the servlet that is invoke. Servlet created a cookie by the name of my_cookie and store the value entered by you in the text, that is a text box of HTML form. So you can further get the information stored in the cookie by another servlet program, that is called the, we discuss by get cookie servlet. So let me discuss what is a cookie. Session management, first, cookie is a small piece of information that persisted between the multiple clients request. Cookie has its name, single value, optional attributes such as command, path, domain qualifier, maximum age, as well as version number. How cookie work? Here the web client is available, and here server or servlet program is available. First, web client request, by default each of the request is considered as a new request, and according to the request, server will reply, that is called the response plus cookie. Here cookie is also available, that retrieve and cookie will send to the server, from the server to client. So this information is stored in client PC. So cookie is stored in the cache of the browser like Opera, Firefox or Chrome browser. Server will add the cookie with response from servlet. This servlet is useful for this response. And finally, request plus cookie we can send. After that, the request is sent by the user. Cookie is added with request by default. Thus, recognize the user as a old user. If cookies is already stored in client browser and we will response to the server, so server automatically assume this client is older or not. Type of the cookie, first one is a non-persistent cookie and persistent cookie. Non-persistent means it is a valid for single session only, not maintain. So it remove each time when user close the browser, while persistent cookie, it is a valid for multiple session, it permanently store. Persistent means permanent, It is not a remove each of the time when user close the browser. It is remove only if user log out or sign out. Cookies class, here the first class use the javax.servlet.http.cookie. This class provide the functionality of using the cookies. It provide lots of useful method for cookies. Here constructor like name of the cookie, same name as a class name, cookies string name as well as string value. So cookie string name comma string value is one constructor. This constructor work with cookie with a specified name and value. Here example of cookie, C is new cookie session id comma id, that is a 054, and this is the cookie object. We can say that this is a cookie object. Method of the cookie like set max age, the return type is void, so void set max age, the parameter integer expiry. So set the maximum age lifetime of cookie in second. Second method integer get max age, that get max age is in the second of this cookie. By default minus one is written, which indicate that cookie will persist until browser shutdown. String get name, so this method return the name of the cookie, and the name can't be changed after the creation. Set value string new value, it assign the new value of the cookie. String get value, so get value current value of the cookie. Other method of the HTTP servlet request and HTTP servlet response like add cookie, we can add the cookies. Cookie get cookies, so it return the array containing of all the cookies object that client send this request. This method return null if cookie were sent. How to create a cookie? For example, we are create one app example for cookie. So cookie is one object, so cookie C is equal to new cookie. We require the name of the cookie as well as here the name of the cookie and value, that is a 054. Adding the cookie in response, so response dot add cookie, and here C is object. How to retrieve the cookie? Cookie C is one array is equal to request dot get cookies. We require the for loop integer I is equal to 0, I less than C dot length, because cookie have some length, it may be a 2 second, 3 second or 4 second. Then last is I plus plus. Out dot print C dot get name, and we retrieve the value, so get value print the name and value of cookie. How to delete a cookie? Read an already existing cookie and store it in cookie object. Set the cookie age as 0 using set max age method to delete an existing cookie. Add this cookie back into the response header. How to delete a cookie? Deleting a value of cookie. Cookie C is equal to new cookie, name of the user, and second parameter we left blank. So changing the maximum age of age to 0 second, and C dot set max age 0. So adding the cookie in response, response dot add cookie C. Cookies dot html, here this file is created. So in the file login id is java, password servlet. By click on sign in button, we retrieve cookie 1.java, that is add cookie, one cookie is added. And second cookie, we retrieve the cookie, add another cookie. Third, we retrieve all the cookies, cookies3.java. So this is the cookie.html file, simple like HTML. We required form action / session cookie 1, login ID, write login name, so it is a type of text, and password is a password type. Input type, we required one button to submit login information. So this type of message will be, or this is the output of cookies.html file. We required cookie1.java file, so simply import here, import io.star, whatever the required for the cookies. Then servlet also, here the name of class is cookies cookie1, it extend http servlet. We required method response.setContentType is text or HTML, so the format of output is in the form of HTML. Print writer out is equal to response.getWriter. String login is equal to request.getParameter, first login and password. If login equal to Java and password is servlet, so we first create the C1 cookie, then C2, same way by clicking on the next object. Cookie name C1 is added, same way we create the cookie 2, nothing is different. C1.length, here for loop is required, integer I is equal to 0, I less than C, I plus plus. So C1.length is 1, cookie name is C1, cookie value is Java. We click on next page, so this is the cookie3.java class. In the third cookie3.java class, we required one for loop, integer I is equal to 0, I less than C.length, I plus plus. Here out.println cookie name, C.getName cookie value we required, and close the connection. So this is a simple cookie name C1, cookie value is Java, C2 cookie value. In the third page, that is a cookie3.java. What is the advantage of cookie? Simplest technique of maintaining the state, cookies are maintained at client side. Simple, it is a, we can maintain easily. But disadvantage of cookie, that it will not work if cookie is disabled from browser. So we can enable or disable cookie by ourselves. Only textual information can be sent in cookie object. This is the interview question related to cookie, like what are the cookies, can I see or view the cookie, I have on my computer. So and the next question, that is what's in the cookie, or what does the cookie contain, why are the cookie used, how long does a cookie last life cycle, age of the cookie, and how secure cookie, what are the tracking cookie, what do the cookie do. Let me discuss the session management. What do you mean by session management? Session management means it is one type of a mechanism used by the web container to store the session information for particular user. So this is already discussed in previous example. HTTP session, it part of our mention. Three-way servlet provide the HTTP session interface, which provide a way to identify user across more than one request. Container create the session ID for each of the user. Container use the ID to identify the particular user. An object of HTTP session can be used to perform two tasks: bind object, or second, view and manipulate the information about a session, such as session identifier, creation time, and last access time. So this is the server and web container, and this servlet, one client make a request, ID is equal to 054. This ID is created like one session is created for servlet. Then second client make a request, that is ID with 054 055, and so we can say that second session is created with ID 054. We required package javax.servlet.http.http session. So this is the hidden content. We required interface. The servlet container use the interface to create a session between HTTP client and HTTP server. Interface means it one type of a communication. It transfer the information from client to server. In this technique, create a session object at server side for each of the client. Session is available until the session timeout, until the client log out. The default session time is 30 minutes and can configure exploited session time in the web.xml file. We all familiar with web.xml, that is a deployment descriptor. We can change this default session. HTTP session that maintain the interface provide to that here the two method to get the object of HTTP session. First one is a get session, HTTP session get session. So it return the current session associated with the request, or if the request doesn't have a session, so create a one. And second method, that is a get session, that is a boolean. It return the current HTTP session associated with the request, or if there is no current session and create is true, return a new session. Method of the HTTP session like string get ID. So it return the string containing the unique identifier value. Log get creation time. So it return the time when this session is created and measure in the millisecond. Log get last access time. So it return the last access time the client sent a request associated with this session as number in millisecond. Void invalid date. Invalid date this session, then unbind any object bound to it. Invalidate means if the session is not validate, so we unbound the object or close the connection. How to create a session? By using HTTP session object, HS is equal to request.getSession, HS.setAttributes. First we required ID, name, and second attributes is value. How to retrieve a session? By using HTTP session object, HS is equal to request.getSession, false, string n is equal to string HS.getAttributes, first attributes. How to invalidate a session? HS.invalidate, this method make a session to invalidate, means it close the connection or unbound the object. HTTP session.html, first login page, hsession1.java that create a session, then hsession2.java that retrieve a session, hsession3 retrieve a session, invalidate session, and last one hsession4.java that is a logout session. Again, whenever we perform the logout, so login page automatically retrieve. So this is the cyclic process. For that you have to require the action session hsession1 get method. So this is the valid ID first we retrieved. Then hsession1, this is a Java file. So in the Java file you required this code, try this code. Same way for hsession2. check the output according to the input. So at session 3, this is the Java class. By performing this Java class, this is the H session 3. Hello again Java, and we click on end session. So by clicking on the end session, we are retrieving the session 4. So in the session 4, we have to write invalidate. Next stage is invalidate state. So here session invalidate is required. So in the fourth one, the message is session invalidate, and after click on logout button, we perform, we retrieve the login page. So session timeout in the web application can be configured in two way: timeout and deployment descriptor web.xml, as well as second timeout with set maximum inactive interval. What do you mean by session timeout? Session timeout in deployment descriptor web.xml. Here the XML file is web under web app. So session configure, name of the session, session timeout. Here we require the time in minute. So 10 is nothing but the minute required to maintain the session, and after 10 minutes session will be timeout. So simply here the value of timeout is set the minute, not in second. Remember this: timeout with set max inactive intervals. So the timeout of current session only can be specified the programmatically via the API of javax.servlet.http http session. So this object http session, session is equal to request.get session, session dot set max. This method is useful like 10 into 60. So here specified time is in second, not a minute. Remember this. This is the most important question related to this unit, like write a servlet program to create a cookie, also write a code to display the content of cookie on page. What is a session? Explain the session management using HTTP session. List the different way to manage the session. Filter API we will discuss in next lecture. Thank you for attending the session.